Hello, I'm now in Australia, and I've actually spent a whole month in Australia already. Been testing the new Olympus OMD M1. You can check out that video. And we're now spending a few days in the Blue Mountains, which is this area right off Sydney, a couple of hours drive, 2-3 hours drive, and it's this first place in nature that you can get to from Sydney that has a bit of hills or mountains, if you want to call it. They call it mountains. We're going to shoot some photos. We're off to a really great start. It's grey and cloudy. I don't think we'll see the sun, but you know. Could be worse. You see, as a photographer, it's also about knowing when not to shoot a photo and to just wait. Which is what we'll do right now. Have a glimmer of hope that there might be a bit of golden light later on, so we'll just have to wait it out. It's fine. I can wait. Still waiting. It's really not looking great. Really not. I think we're gonna have to shoot sunrise. Good morning. That was a short night. 5 hours sleep. And now I thought, you know what? The morning spot. Sunrise spot is going to be awesome. You just drive there, get out, get there in time and shoot. Turns out it's a fire trail. And the last 5 kilometers, I'm going to have to walk. Basically, I'm trying to beat sunrise right now. So I'm trying to run with my backpack and walk whenever I'm too exhausted to run. So let's go, right? Go. Yeah, you can see the sun rising already. It's about 5:15 in the morning. Sun rises at 5:45, so I'm gonna have to run 5k in half an hour. As you can see, I missed sunrise. Let's go. Is now hitting that rock. It's beautiful. I'm getting such a contrast. Oh, loving it. Let's talk a little bit about composition in this area here. I think this golden rock and the way it leans into the shot is this perfect example of having a foreground that pulls you into a shot, and then the foreground that pulls you into the middle gets your eye into the distance, and that's how your eye travels into the shot, and now that's how you create depth. And I think that is the most important thing in a photograph, is to create depth by layering, by using contrast, by using foreground, something in the middle, something in the distance. So there's all these tools, there's colors, there's contrast, there's light, and this is one of those places where it really works really well, because we have this beautiful foreground and this amazing backdrop just right behind us, and we have contrast this morning. We have a little bit of color. We have this yellow warm color in the foreground, the blue dark color in the background, all these things, and I'm loving it. The light is coming in and out. Look at that. Sorry for the wind. I hope you can hear me. Fortunately, I don't control the weather. So what I'm going to do is use this, what I was talking about, this composition. We're going to use this vantage point to be the floating vantage point. So actually, my
Sorry about that. I think I'll need a new filter. It's really windy. Camera still works, so that's good. So what I'll be using is this position. Like I was saying, I'll be using this position to be the floating vantage point of this shot. I'm gonna wait for the light to come in and light up my rock formation in the front. Okay, I'm gonna have to wait for the sun. I'll wait it out, see if it'll look good. I think I got some, one or two good shots earlier on when the sun was lower and sort of diffused a bit through the clouds, and there was that bright red light on the rocks. So we might have to just do with that and call that a day until sunset for now. Yeah, not easy. I have no idea how glad I am to be back at this car. That was a long hike. I know it's only 10 kilometers, but at 5 a.m. I didn't expect it. So, what makes a good shot these days, right? Everyone has a camera. Well, I think everyone has a different opinion about that, but what really matters is not just the composition and the colors, the contrast, all the things that I try to like share how I take the photos. But I think a good shot these days is more about the story you can tell, that goes behind the shot. So if I had to just run 5K because I was too late and there was a fire trail and I didn't do my research, well, that makes a really good story to my hopefully good shot. That's what really makes a shot these days, is the whole package of not just the great composition, but I think it's also if you have a great story to tell behind it. And that might be the person in your shot that is, you know, the subject of your shot might be a great story. Or it might be the photographer itself. Nowadays, everyone's a photographer. Maybe we should all tell our own stories through our photography. So I try to have an adventure while I take my photos. And I try to share those adventures with you so you realize not just the compositions and all the techniques, but you realize the story behind the shot. And I think that's what photographers nowadays should be doing, telling stories with their shots, not just through their shots. Yesterday we came down here for a walk in the afternoon, and I'm not gonna get any photos, I'm just gonna enjoy the walk. I thought it was all going to be dry and harsh light, typical Australian afternoon light where taking photos is really just a bad idea, right? So I thought I'd just enjoy the walk. Turns out it's incredibly tropical down here and very, very different from what I thought it was. It's actually this green, lush, beautiful canyon. So I decided to come back this morning and hopefully get there with a different mood, with better light, and hopefully get there with all my gear as well. Mountains, believe it or not. Yesterday we were up on these huge viewpoints, these dry yellow vast landscapes, and now we've come down deep down into the canyons and it's a completely different landscape. It's tropical, it's green, it's lush, and it's a really tight space, so it's almost the exact opposite of what we had at the top. So I'm gonna try and shoot a photo down here that shows the scale of these cliffs that are hanging over and how lush and green it is down here. So let's go. So how do we capture the depth and the scale and this colors down here? Well, there's three things from a gear point of view. I'm using a 105mm Lee circular polarizer, which allows me to take out all those reflections here. Everything is wet down here, and all the skylight is basically bouncing off all the surfaces. So this polarizer will cut out all those reflections, and it'll show the green and the colors below the wet surfaces. The next thing is to use a really wide lens. A really wide lens will make everything look big that's close up, and everything that's far away will look much smaller. It helps show you the scale and the depth of a place. I'm using a 7-14mm f2.8 Pro Olympus lens. And the next thing is to use a tripod, because there's not that much light down here, and you'll need a fair amount of long exposures to capture everything, every single detail in the shadows and the highlights, mostly in the shadows. And I don't need a tripod, and I'm really glad. I don't like tripods. They sort of freeze you in the spot, and a lot of photographers set up a tripod and they won't move until they're happy with their shot. But basically, a lot of the times it's about moving and actually finding a new foreground, a new perspective on things. Now, I'm using the Olympus OMD EM1 Mark II, and that allows me to shoot handheld exposures of up to 3, 4, 5 seconds with this lens here, which is truly amazing. There's no other camera that I know of that can do this. It has sensor stabilization, and it compensates for all the shake and movement that I do during that time of the exposure. All right, I found this great spot. We have this beautiful tree that's fallen over and leaning across this canyon, and we have this beautiful fern that's in the foreground, and this bridge or this path that goes across, and we'll have the river flowing into the distance into the canyon. That's it for this week's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something, and I hope I encourage you to go outside and maybe check out the Blue Mountains if you're ever in the area of Sydney. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Maybe leave a comment, a question, or anything below. I try to respond to every comment and question, and check out the blog post. There's a ton of extra information there as well. That's also linked below, and you'll find a lot about the settings of the camera. You'll find the gear I'm using, the techniques I'm using, and the locations of where the shots were taken. If you really love my work, maybe consider buying one of my Lightroom preset packs. They come with 10 to 15 presets, and they allow you to speed up your editing workflow and add a certain style to your photos. I've also linked those in the bottom. They're not expensive, and they really helped me produce these episodes for you guys. So thanks for you guys who have bought one. If you haven't yet, consider it. I hope to see you next time. Until then, keep on shooting. It helps you bring in the scale of this place. It'll help you show how deep and how I've lost it.